the New England Patriots might be all set at quarterback, but Brady is in his 40s, and they're definitely a team that tends to invest in the long term. Now, in the past two drafts, they had a total of one late second round pick. And now in the 2018 draft, they have four picks in the first two rounds of the draft. And when it comes to it all, there's some rumors here and there that they might move up in the draft or whatnot, or they might just stay put with their picks and might select somebody. And there definitely needs at left tackle. They probably will need a second corner, and they might need some help when it comes to the front seven. But for one thing for sure, maybe in the short term, they might not need a quarterback, but in the long term, that's definitely a top priority. And this is a quarterback draft right here. There's rumors that there's going to be five quarterbacks taking the top 10 of this draft. And there's some interesting like late picks in this draft too, whether it's Mason Rudolph, Luke Falk, or Kyle Loletta. And I'm going to be talking about all a bunch of these guys right here. And I'm going to start off with some of the big names first and maybe rule out some guys here. Now, one guy I typically want to rule out is Lamar Jackson. Lamar Jackson doesn't seem to be one of their guys. I mean, I've heard maybe they could take a look at Lamar Jackson. I bet they are. However, though, just his style of play doesn't seem to fit what they are trying to do. And then another guy I definitely have some things about is Baker Mayfield. Now, when it comes to Mayfield and whatnot, he might have that love for football that they might be looking for, but I don't think he has the exact kind of mentality that they kind of want in New England right here. I think Mayfield, it would be a great fit for Mayfield. However, though, it wouldn't be a great fit for Belichick. And this is Belichick we're talking about. Who is he going to draft? Who is he going to polish right here? Sure, on the field, he brings to the table what they want to probably do at quarterback. However, though, when it comes to him, he seems like he has a lot of anxiety on his hands, like, and he doesn't seem to be a big game performer or whatnot, and he might not have that quarterback personality that they're probably looking for. And then there's another guy in Josh Allen. Josh Allen might have that big cannon arm that they look at, but he just doesn't seem like there's nothing that really kind of pops up to his thing. I mean, sure, he went through some adversity right here, but those are definitely some guys on the route. Now, another guy I might not want to rule out is Sam Darnold, who's the guy with the highest floor in this draft. I've said that in the past couple of my videos and whatnot. And Darnell's definitely a guy where he might not be picked first overall, and the Giants might rather select Bradley Chubb, which is, there's no disrespect there, but then Saquon Barkley. Barkley could be a great running back, but quarterback trumps running back any day of the week. And then the Jets could take Baker Mayfield because he kind of has that swagger right there, quarterback. Maybe the Jets kind of want that playmaking ability. And Darnell could be a little bit of a playmaker too. I think that they would pick Darnell in that spot, but there is a possibility Darnell could have that experience where he drops in the draft. Another guy that could drop in the draft is that Josh Rosen guy, just because of his personality. And I personally think Josh Rosen is the guy who I personally think is going to be the best quarterback out of this entire draft and whatnot. But he definitely does have a little bit of a small frame here. There definitely doesn't have that right there. I think he just fits New England just because of that pocket presence right there and all that, just that passer that they would definitely want. And then let's look at some of the later guys. Now, another guy they probably looked at is Mason Rudolph. And when it comes to Mason Rudolph, Rudolph is definitely a guy who's big, he's strong. I believe his brother was a linebacker, so there is definitely some athleticism with him. I don't think he has the accuracy that I think a lot of quarterbacks have. Obviously, accuracy is one of the most important attributes when it comes to quarterbacking. Definitely got to look at where's the quarterback throwing the ball. Does it look like a perfect pass? Is he throwing a tight spiral? It's a little bit of questions, Mason Rudolph. However, though, he definitely does have a quarterback personality, and that's something that they're probably going to definitely look at. Kind of reminds me a little bit of a Jimmy Garoppolo, I'm not going to lie. And I think another late-round guy would be Kyle Loletta, because Kyle Loletta is a guy who came from a Division II school, and they did draft Jimmy Garoppolo, came from a Division II school. And Kyle was from a school called the Richmond Spiders. Obviously, that sounds like a Madden 12 custom team right there, but it is a legit sports team. I believe his father was in the Navy or something, so it's a military background. Bill Belichick was in the Navy and whatnot. That's what they tend to look at right there. And not only that, he is accurate at times. I definitely think he has that accuracy thing right there that people definitely look at. And then you got another guy, Luke Falk. Luke Falk is one of these guys who was projected third or fourth round. No, he's not super accurate. There's, like, he has some good accuracy moments here and there, but he's not the most accurate in the world. But he does come through the clutch moments, and he does have gone through a lot of adversity, and that's something that a lot of people would definitely look at. Now, I would think that there's some quarterbacks that they looked at. I think they've looked at Mayfield. They've looked at Darnell. They are looking at Rudolph. They're looking at Kyle Loyletta. And they're also looking at Luke Falk and whatnot. And I think those are definitely some things you could definitely talk about. And I just want to say, when it comes to a guy like Darnell and Mayfield, I think they're just going to be off the board by that point. And Mayfield just doesn't seem to be their guy when it comes to his personality. And I look at a guy similar to Mason Rudolph. I think the Steelers are going to pick Rudolph right there. I think he kind of fits what they're kind of doing. Kind of reminds me what they kind of want to look at do and all of that. And I think it's Luke Falk and Kyle Loyletta are the guys to look at right here. So I want to narrow it down to the late round guys, these kind of these no names, because they haven't drafted a high profile quarterback in a long time. They really have not. And I think when it comes to, if I had to pick one, it's really a coin flip right here. Luke Falk, I believe his favorite quarterback is Tom Brady. When they drafted Jimmy Garoppolo, Jimmy Garoppolo's favorite quarterback was Brady when they drafted him back in 2014. So that's definitely something right there. But then you got a guy who has better accuracy with Kyle Loyletta and also has connections with the Navy right here. So there is some of that right there, but then Luke Falk kind of has the edge with his clutchness versus Kyle doesn't have the same one. So it's definitely those two guys right there. I had to pick a coin flip. I think they're going to go with Kyle Loyletta just because he was in the Navy and whatnot, just because he's right there. Now, when it comes to all these reports and whatnot, have I heard reports of them looking into Josh Rosen, Lamar Jackson, Josh Allen? No, not really. I haven't heard them drop any interviews right here and there. But I definitely am open up to some guys right here. I mean, there's even rumors that they might sign Johnny Manziel. And that would be absolutely insane if they brought in Johnny Football right there, the BN New England. But overall, guys, I've been talking way too much. What do you guys think? Leave your comments down below. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.